According to Regan, the co-founder of Date for Climate Uganda, the historical significance and visionary goals that inspired nations towards a more just and equitable global economic landscape have not been followed. The like-minded youth and climate enthusiasts are also urging G77 plus China to prioritize transparency in decision making.
I believe we need the money, but one thing that we must look at is the systems have been created in a way that we must always go and borrow. And we cannot do away with borrowing. So we have to go and borrow and borrow and borrow and borrow every time. So that is how the international system has been created and doesn't give us a gap for us maybe to depend on ourselves and also maybe to...
Cynthia Kemigisa, the head of communication at the Uganda Council of Foreign Relations, stresses the need for clear information to ensure understanding and support from the broader community. The debate for climate global south position and policy statement to the G77 chair encompasses several critical points.
Empowering youth is an investment. In the future, we advocate for mentorship programs, capacity building initiatives, and platforms for youth to actively contribute to the G77 plus China activities. Recognizing the initiative, the innovative ideas, and the energy that the youth bring, their inclusion is vital for shaping policies that resonate with the realities of the present and the aspirations of...
We also want to see the G77 pushing at the United Nations level and also at COP29 pushing a just transition from what we have been calling fossil fuels to renewable energy from so which has been one of the major discussions.
And also aims at ending financial neocolonial approaches. The youth called for G77 unity against financial neocolonial approaches by America and European countries. Story by Rachel Nachwala for the news.